John Thompson walked off the court and refused to coach an NCAA game as a way of standing up and speaking out. So as we watch these NBA players today standing up and speaking out and walking off the court, we got to recognize that John Thompson laid down the foundation for that kind of practice. The sports world has lost a giant. The great John Thompson has passed away. By any measure, John Thompson is a basketball legend. He was a three-time city champion in high school. He was an All-American in college. He won the NBA championship every year he was in the league. He was, by all measures, a basketball success story as a player. Then as a coach, he goes to Georgetown and wins a national championship in 1984 after turning around a broken program. He led so many legendary players to the league: Dikembe Mutombo, Alonzo Mourning, Allen Iverson. The list goes on. He was a special coach. But what makes John Thompson a legend is not just his basketball success. It was what he did and who he was with regard to the people he coached, to the community he built, to the legacy he left. When the NCAA imposed Proposition 48 and later Proposition 42, which were both designed to make it harder for black athletes to get into college and to succeed, he pointed out that the SAT was racist. He pointed out that there were systems in place in the NCAA that made it harder for inner city and lower socioeconomic status kids to get into the league. He recognized the structural problems, but he didn't just speak out against it boldly, which was a big deal. John Thompson walked off the court and refused to coach an NCAA game as a way of standing up and speaking out. So as we watch these NBA players today standing up and speaking out and walking off the court, we got to recognize that John Thompson laid down the foundation for that kind of practice. John Thompson loved his players. In the height of the 80s, when drug crews were tearing up DC, he saw a particular drug crew influencing his players, coming too close to his players, and he put his body, he put his life on the line to stand up against those men and say, "You do not come near my players. You will not ruin their lives." That's the kind of man John Thompson was. When Allen Iverson was placed in a prison cell, when he was charged with multiple felonies, when every other college in the world said no to Allen Iverson, even though he was the best basketball player and one of the best football players on the planet, John Thompson didn't let Allen Iverson go. He didn't allow the world to throw him away. He met with Allen Iverson's mom. He met with Allen Iverson. He gave him a scholarship. He gave him a chance. He saved his life. That's why at Allen Iverson's Hall of Fame induction ceremony, he pointed out the fact that he wouldn't be there without John Thompson.
No other teams, no other schools would recruit me anymore. My mom went to Georgetown and begged him to give me a chance. And he did.
But it's important for us to recognize that he ain't just stand in the gap for Allen Iverson. He stood in the gap for generations of black athletes to come. He laid the foundation for pros to come. He continued a legacy of activism and truth-telling that transcends the NCAA, that transcends basketball, that transcends sport. John Thompson was a true hero, a true freedom fighter, a true giant. May he rest in peace.